Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to use Outline View in Microsoft Word. The Outline View can help you organize new or existing documents, including moving whole sections without cutting and pasting. First, we'll open the Outline View. Then, we'll enter and change the outline levels. Lastly, we'll rearrange the outline and customize the view. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to Word for Mac and the recent single purchase versions of the software. These steps don't currently apply to Word for the web. Before we jump in, it's important to note that you can use Outline View to create a new outline, as we'll do today, or use it to organize existing documents arranged with Word's built-in headings. For information about headings, please see my previous tutorial linked below. Begin by selecting the View tab, followed by Outline in the Views group. From the Outlining tab, select the level you want to create from the Outline Level menu. Each outline level will convert to the corresponding heading level in the document. Next, type the text. And then press the Enter key on a PC or Return key on a Mac to move to the next line. From there, you can select a new level from the Outline Level menu, including selecting body text to insert regular text. You can also press the Tab key on your keyboard to move to a lower level, or press Shift plus Tab to move to a higher level. In addition, the green arrows on either side of the Outline Level menu will move you up or down the levels. In Outline View, you can move levels with their subordinate levels or move each level independently of its subordinates. To move a level with its subordinates, hover your pointer over the plus or minus sign next to the item until your pointer becomes a four-headed arrow. Then drag the selection up or down to a new location. Alternatively, you can select the plus or minus sign next to the item, and then use the move up or move down arrows to move the selection. If you want to move a level without its subordinates, click just inside that text, and then use the move up or move down arrows to move the selection. You can customize the view of your outline without actually altering any of the content. For example, select the plus or minus sign next to the level, and then use the expand and collapse buttons to open or close the level. The Show Level menu lets you show the lowest level you want to see. For example, if you select Level 2, you'll see levels 1 and 2, but not levels 3 or below. Select or deselect Show Text Formatting to see formatting, such as heading fonts, boldness, and italics in the outline. And select or deselect Show First Line Only to see only the first line of each item. Multi-line items will be represented by an ellipsis at the end of the line. If you want to add formatting to your outline, select the text, and then right-click on a PC or Control-click on a Mac to open the shortcut menu. From there, select Font to open the Font dialog box, which offers many formatting options. Most PC users will also have the option of formatting directly from the mini toolbar. Formatting added in the outline will then appear in the document, which you can always return to by selecting the Close Outline View button. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlists, How to Use Microsoft Word, and How to Use Word for Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.